Hello and welcome to this session of Q&A Friday. On this channel, Automation Step by Step, I meet you every Friday and I take up one question asked by you and try to answer to the best of my knowledge and experience. So today, we are taking up a question asked by Ritesh, and Ritesh says, can you please let us know about penetration testing? Ritesh, thank you for asking this question. So let us understand in a very basic and easy way what penetration testing is. So penetration testing, also called as pen testing, is a process of testing the security weaknesses of an application, system or a network. In other words, we try to find out how secure our network, applications or systems are and what are the chances or possibilities of our applications being hacked or attacked. Let us understand this in a very easy way. Suppose you build your house. Now your house will have multiple entry points. It will have some doors and windows and so on. And these are important to let you in and out of the house. However, you want that only the people of your family or your friends, or in other words, only the people who are authorized to enter your house should enter your house and nobody else. So you want to check that what are the possibilities or what are the security weaknesses of the entry and exit systems of your house, and what are the possibilities of somebody breaking into your house. To test this, you can call an expert who expertises in house security. So this person will come and check your house for all the security measures, and he will actually try to break into your house using all the possible means. And at the end of this test, he will create a report where he will show you what are all the weaknesses, the security weaknesses in your house systems, and he can also give you some recommendations. For example, he can say that you need to put on some security alarms, or you want to put up some electronic safety measures and so on. Now this is exactly what happens in a pen test. A person who is expertise or who is authorized to do a pen test tries to break into the application network and systems, and then tries to find out all the security weaknesses, and at the end produces a report which shows what are the security weaknesses, and he can also give some recommendations on that. And then the person can again do a test to check if the system is now secure or do we have some other security weaknesses. So one of the primary reasons why you should do a pen test is something we have already discussed, that you want to test the security weaknesses of your applications, and basically you want to make your systems and applications and networks more secure, and do not want that anybody who is not authorized should break into your system. The second major reason of doing a pen test is the owners of the applications wants to make their system secure. However, they do not want to spend millions of dollars in setting up all the safety measures and security systems on their applications. They want only the security measures or safety measures that are required and not everything else. So for that, they want somebody to do a test and tell them that what are the security weaknesses, and they will only spend the money to make sure that these security weaknesses are covered, and they do not have to spend a lot on setting up the security measures that they do not actually need. So these are two major reasons that anybody would want to do a pen test on their systems. So if you are a penetration tester, or even if you want to learn pen testing, make sure of a couple of things. Only try to test the systems that you are legally allowed to do so. For example, do not try to break into any other systems. Do not try to break into your friend's Facebook account. That is both illegal and wrong. And when I say you should not break into anybody else's account, that does not mean that you have all the rights to break into your own account. For example, do not try to break into your own Facebook account. That can make your account locked forever and then you will lose everything. So always have a system which is only for tests, so that if that account gets locked or something bad happens, you are not worried. Also, always have a separate environment or a separate system to do penetration testing. Do not start doing pen test on your own computer or laptop, because again, it can crash your system and then it will be a big problem for you. You will lose everything. So always have a separate system. So even if everything goes wrong and the system crashes, you are not worried and you do not compromise on your data and security and other things. So basically the rule is that you can test something which you are allowed to do so. So suppose you are a pen tester and then you are hired by somebody to do a pen testing on their system, always have a written permission from them. Even if it is your own organization, always have something written communicated to you that you are allowed to do so, and then you can go ahead with your testing. So basically there are two types of penetration testing or pen testing, the white box and the black box. The white box pen testing is a testing where the tester knows about the system's configurations and details, and then using this information he tries to gather some more information and then tries to break into the accounts and applications and try to see how secure the applications are. There is another kind of testing called as black box pen test, and here the tester only knows the public information which is accessible to anybody else. For example, the website URLs, the domains, the company name and so on. He does not know the internal details and configurations. So whatever information he has, he uses that to gain some other information, some deeper information, and then tries to break into the system. So these are basically the two types of testing. If we talk about the methods of penetration testing, then we have the manual method as well as the automated method. So in manual, there will be a person who is skilled and who has the expertise, and along with his skills, he will use some tools for pen testing and then do a manual testing on the systems. When we talk about automation pen test, then we will set up a framework or some scripts along with some tools which will do a pen testing in an automated way. And the advantage here is that once this entire system of testing is set up with all the scripts and frameworks and tools, we can reuse it on every iteration. So after every build or before every release of the product, the company can just run this automated pen test, and then they can have the reports and they can validate the security weaknesses of their systems. Coming to the tools for penetration testing, there are basically two categories of pen testing tools, the static analysis tools and the dynamic analysis tools. Now, if we talk about the tools in details, it will take longer. So we will have a separate session where I will talk about the tools for penetration testing. So we will wrap up this session today here. Also, just for information, I will share that in real world, the owners of the application, when they do pen testing, sometimes they inform their security teams that they are doing, they have hired somebody, or there is somebody who is going to do a pen testing on their systems, and there will be some security alarms and so on. So these will be false alarms. Don't get intimidated by these alarms. However, the owners of the application might choose to do not inform their security teams before doing this pen test. The reason here is they want to test how ready and prepared their security teams are in case of an actual attack. So they want to test that if somebody attacks the application, how quickly can the security team respond and get the things resolved. So this is on a real world and the actual world, this is what happens. I hope you liked today's session of Q&A Friday. In case you want me to speak on some other similar topics or any other topic related to automation, testing, DevOps and CI, do let me know and mention in the comments, and I will take up that question in the coming sessions of Q&A Friday. Also, if you like the session, please hit the like button and share with others. If you have not yet subscribed to this channel, please do subscribe by hitting the subscribe button below. I will meet you in the next session of Q&A Friday. Thanks for watching.